Stoke had to wait 4 years to end their chase to sign Eric Maxim Choupo-Moting.It must have seemed like a lifetime for boss Mark Hughes, but he will be thinking it was well worth it as he became the first player to score against Manchester United this season. Better than that, he got a second as he threatened to be a one-man wrecking ball on United's 100% record. But the one thing you know about any Jose Mourinho side is that they are probably going to be at their most dangerous when they have been hurt. There were times when they had almost toyed with Stoke in a one-sided first half, but lapses in concentration from defenders Eric Bailey and Phil Jones saw them trail for the first time since they kicked off the new Premier League season 4 weeks ago. Mourinho said, "No, I'm not satisfied with a point because we were the team closer to winning. I have to say it is a result I accept though. One team tried to win, one team tried to get the point, but they fought hard to get that point, they defended well, they counter-attacked and in set pieces are powerful." "I'm happy with Romelu Lukaku with or without goals because his contribution is always good. One team tried to win, one team tried to get the point with one more goal we went 3-2, but without the mistake at the corner then we went 2-1 and Lukaku's miss doesn't matter. Potter's skipper Darren Fletcher, who had spent 20 years of his career at Old Trafford, silenced the terrace critics making fun of his new blond rants, with a sweeping crossfield pass. Bailey played Mame Diouf onside and Jones did not go with the German-born Cameroon new boy. And both Diouf and Choupo-Moting capitalized on their sloppiness. The Senegal international's cross was met sweetly by the Stoke winger, who joined them on a 3-year deal after being out of contract at Bundesliga side Schalke. He had jumped at the opportunity to play in the Premier League, knowing Stoke had been keen on him for a while. He swept home the centre to get off the mark in his third star to further enhance Hughes' reputation as a manager who can outwit and upset the big beasts. He had already masterminded Stoke's 1-0 win over Arsene Wenger's Arsenal in his opening home game and must have had fleeting thoughts of a memorable early season double. But instead of protecting their lead for the 2 minutes of the first half that remained, Stoke fell for a sucker punch, although there was more than a slice of luck about it. Henrik Mkhitaryan swung in a corner from the left, Nemanja Matic helped it on at the near post and Paul Pogba headed it onto Marcus Rashford's head, taking the ball beyond Jack Butland. Hughes was raging on the touchline and most of the Stoke City players remonstrated with referee Neil Swarbrick, urging him to talk with his linesman. They were convinced the teenager had strayed offside. But Swarbrick and the linesman were absolutely right to ignore all the protests and allow the goal to stand. Manchester United have made a happy habit of turning the screw after a halftime lesson from their manager. And it was the same story only 12 minutes into the second half. Joe Allen clumsily lost the ball and turned away in disgust rather than trying to recover. Two passes later, Lukaku was presented with a one-on-one with Butland. The England keeper stopped his first effort, but the Belgium star clipped the loose ball into the net for his ninth goal in his last seven games for club and country. But at least Stoke have shown that perhaps United are not the invincibles some are suggesting after they won their first three games with 10 goals and 3 clean sheets. And it was the new Potteries goal hero who put them level on 63 minutes, seconds after David De Gea had pulled off a wonder save from Jose. The United fans behind his goal were still singing his praises when he was beaten, the backpedaling Jones slipping to give Choupo-Moting a clear header. This time De Gea had not got a chance of stopping Stoke from drawing level as he buried his opportunity. With Pep Guardiola temporarily warding it at the head of the table after Manchester City's 5-2 demolition of Liverpool in the lunchtime kickoff, there was plenty of incentive for Mourinho to make it 4 Premier League wins in a row. But Hughes, the only boss to have won more than two home games against Mourinho, had clearly got his side up for the fight. The last time the Red Devils fans enjoyed the 46-mile trip back to Manchester celebrating 3 points was in April 2013. Since then Stoke have claimed 2 wins and now 3 draws, although it could have been so different if Lukaku had not hooked over.